what do you actually fear when you fear failure?
Criticism.
One thing, exactly. So one thing, of course, you fear is, hey, I'll lose my job and I'll be on the road. But the truth is that you will find another job. And if you develop a reputation for being honest, forthright, and come up with ideas, leaders in your company will spot that. What is it about criticism that bothers us? It bothers us because somewhere it questions our own self-concept. It's a question of your own self-concept. This fear of failure is an internal one. Because somewhere you are not confident that I'm good enough. Somewhere you're saying, maybe I'm good enough, let me go out and see. If you tie your self-concept instead to your status as somebody who gives 100% and tries the hardest, then you will not be bothered. I tried my best. Maybe I got it wrong. Maybe this person is saying that you're wrong. Maybe he's saying it harshly. So what? I gave it my best. So my concept of myself is not threatened. But instead, if I say I'm this person who always gets things right, then the moment something goes wrong and someone criticizes me, I'll feel hurt. Because your concept is tied instead to your status as somebody who always gets things right. This is ego. This is what actually, sometimes even successful entrepreneurs fall prey to this. So I come from the investing world. In investments, ego and attachment are, you know, killers. You can't afford to get attached to your positions. You have to, you know, be humble enough to accept that things have changed and change your mind. So, you know, Lord Keynes, the famous economist, used to frequently change his mind on things. So somebody criticized him for that. Ek aisa economist hai, har bar mind change karte rehta. So he said one very profound statement. He said, when the facts contradict my opinion, I change my mind. What do you do when the facts contradict your opinion? So you have to be humble enough to change.